Okay, we're rolling.
We are rolling. Hey, everybody. First of all, thank you to my camera person or video person who's back there behind there, my smoking hot wife, Kay.
Thanks,
as
Mom.
Everybody knows. And as you all know, I'm Kelly's dad. Hello, everybody. Steve Miller, better known as Kelly's dad and marketing gunslinger. And
I'm Kelly.
This is Kelly. Here we go. So we just spent 4 days of epic golf at Bandon Dunes Resort in Bandon, Oregon. That was pretty crazy, wasn't it?
Yes.
Great golf.
A lot of good golf. A lot of good weather.
Oh my gosh, we just absolutely nailed the weather and everything like that. But I promised everybody last week, last week I talked to Kay, what did we chat about last week? Do you remember? Oh, we talked about
Nebraska.
Yes. Yeah, boy, got a lot of comments about that from people, and a lot of people liked that a lot. And then I said, okay, since I'm going to be with Kelly, and Kelly is in sales as well at Callaway Golf, so I'm going to ask her to tell us a little bit about sales. First of all, tell us about how long have you been at Callaway?
Almost 4 years. I started in the customer service side and moved on to sales, where I've been for almost 2 years now.
Yeah, in sales now. So she's kicking it. And I said, you know what? Let's find out. She's young and she's into sales and she's in kind of a male-dominated industry. And I thought, what has she picked up in the couple of years that she's been involved in sales and also, the customer service thing. So I asked her to think of three things that she could share with us. What did you come up with? What's the first one that you came up with?
First thing I came up with is important, and I think this is kind of a no-brainer that is often not thought about and not utilized, is just kind of a constant sense of urgency and attention to detail overall.
A constant sense of urgency.
Yes.
And what do you mean by that? What?
I think from a day-to-day servicing perspective, I'm dealing with the same customers, of course, day-to-day, and so, I have the same kind of client base, and so just kind of the follow-up piece and, kind of getting back to them and just being on top of things, and they know that when they call that I'm there, and if I don't have a solution right then they know that I'm working quickly to find it for them, and I'm not going to leave them hanging in any way.
Okay. All right. Cool. So that's the first one?
Yes.
All right. What's the second thing that you picked up?
Do what you say you're going to do.
that's kind of important, isn't it? And that's a really good point, because I know that salespeople tend to kind of say, oh yeah, sure, I'll take care of that for you or something.
I think it's the most obvious thing and also underutilized, where in the reality, if you're gonna follow up with someone or if you're gonna say that you're gonna do something and you actually do it, a lot of times the other service people that they're working with from other companies or, other avenues are not doing that. And so it's a basic part of the job, and yet it completely sets you apart.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So we've got sense of urgency, and then do what you say you're going to do. All right. And then, we also mentioned that you're in a male-dominated industry, which is kind of odd. I mean, golf, yes, I can understand. But it seems, I'm very surprised when Kelly told us that there weren't as many women salespeople in the industry as I would have thought that there would be. But you had to kind of deal with that. I mean, we were laughing about the fact that even when we were going to Bandon Dunes, Kelly emailed somebody there at Bandon to just say, hey, I'm coming up, I'm from Callaway, and industry stuff, right? And the response?
Yeah, so it was a simple email, my email signature, Kelly Miller, and he said, happy to help with the father-son trip.
Yep, father-son trip, absolutely.
Which is a common...
Yeah, so it's kind of an assumed thing that there's so many male, it's mainly male.
Well, one thing to be said, there wasn't a single women's bathroom on the golf course.
That's true.
It was men's room and a gender neutral, which, hey...
Oh well,
that's
their client base. Exactly right. So, so you said you said there was something about working in a male-dominated industry that you could share.
Yeah, and I think this is easy for me. I've grown up around golf, and so I've grown up around a lot of guys and stuff. But talk to people how they talk to each other. Cater to the personality that you're dealing with. And and as far as being a female working with someone, that doesn't mean I have to be overly polite compared to the next person. I talk to them exactly how I feel like a male salesperson would talk to them. Obviously, you're catering to different relationships and stuff, but I think a lot of times, sometimes the female side is to be more proper and more, you know, I guess courteous and stuff. But in reality, it's just a conversation, you know, kind of working with them, how they work with...
Dudes talking to dudes, you know.
Bro out as much as they...
Bro out.
go as bro-y as they go.
Well, that's good. Well, we had an amazing time in Bandon, and Kelly is getting ready to fly back to San Diego, get back to work tomorrow, and Kay and, you know, Kay and I will obviously hit the road, and we'll be back in the office tomorrow as well. So thanks again to my special guest this week. Might have to have her back again. We could do a Zoom call or something like that, you know. But Steve Miller, better known as Kelly's dad, marketing gunslinger, and
Kay Miller, the smoking hot wife.
That's right. And I'll be back again next week with another Uncopyable Branding, Uncopyable Business program. And always remember, be uncopyable. See ya.